Hey designers, welcome back to this channel. I'm Kim, I'm a product designer from New York City, and today on this channel, well, always on this channel, we talk about XR, future tech, and design. And I thought I would do this video to break down some of my findings from the World Wide Web, speaking to a lot of creators within the industry, looking at job postings to be specific, on what skills and tools are useful for you to know as a product designer trying to get into the VR space. I do want to mention that this is under the lens of a product designer because that is what I am, and this is mainly focused towards people that are interested in getting in, don't know really where. This may help address a lot of people that have similar backgrounds to design, regardless of it. I do want to mention that while I am not directly in the field, because of the small projects that I have been creating on the side, I really have been getting offers, surprisingly, for projects within the XR field. So I'm looking to really dive deeper, share anything that I can, because I find this field to be there are so many parts to it. And there are so many ways to make these certain prototypes and apps and experiences that it's easy to get confused. And that's why I made my Notion hub of resources for XR design in hopes to sort of aggregate everything that's on the web. But that being said, I am gonna get into skills and tools, and hopefully you'll walk away with learning or feeling like you know what you can tackle next and learn that, and also feeling less overwhelmed by maybe what you don't need to know because you will already do it in your day-to-day. So with that being said, let's jump into it, covering skills first. If you have worked in a product design role, you already have a good idea of how iterating, working on a team is like, project management, UI design, and prototyping, how all of that fits into building a product. Needless to say, the design process does vary by company, as usual, and the VR design process does follow a game development process. Now, if you're interested into what exactly that's like, I will link below a talk from Google. They made their VR design process public. It's from 2016, so it's a little dated, but it's worth looking at and, you know what, taking notes on. Always do your homework. And I'm bringing all of this up because there are product design roles specifically at these VR companies. And if you just look up the roles, you'll just really get a lot of insight into what they're looking for on the product design path. So do your homework, always look that up. But in general, let's jump into some useful fields in case you didn't come from a product design background. That being said, general design roles are wonderful for design thinking and knowing the foundations of design. Architecture, and I apologize, I am looking at my laptop because I have a lot of notes that, you know what, I will possibly make public after this video. Anyway, go back to it. Architecture and industrial design, really great for designing spatially, which, take note of that. Photography, surprisingly, and why would that be? Because of lighting, depth of field, camera angle, CAD, since you're designing 3D objects. And lastly, but not finally, game design, of course, because the VR design process does follow closely a game design process. If you have never played video games ever before, now is absolutely your time to start, because in exposure, we are observing so much. And by so much, let me just say, you learn interactions, you learn storytelling, you learn how characters interact with each other, how to bring awareness to an object, and that's just the start. So to start doing your homework by playing video games to learn more of this field, let's jump into user research. Now, the funny thing is that user research, a lot of times I always get asked, how is user research involved in VR and stuff like that? And it's so funny because if we're making a product for people, we always have to consider user research, UX design, and so on and so forth. So user research, the why we're doing it doesn't change just because it's in VR. We still care about people. We still care about making the best product for people as possible. So we are absolutely still going to research what their interests are, how the experience that we just created, how it turns out for them, and usability tests, and iterate on that. It doesn't end just because it's a VR experience. In fact, it's just a little bit different, but the foundation elements there for user research are still very much there. Now, this is a pro tip. This is something that I've done and I've only shared with few, but if you want insight into the user research process for VR, sign up to be a research participant for Facebook Reality Labs. It's literally what I did, and you can reverse engineer why they're asking you certain questions, and you know why they might be asking you those certain questions and what kinds of questions they're asking, to get a better insight into the process of user research for VR, AR, literally anything, even just basic user research. Always think of it that way. If you can be a participant and take part, do it. Now let's jump into tool. This may be the biggest learning curve for us all traditional 2D product designers. Of course, we're so used to working with websites and apps and these things we can use and do use every single day. So, and of course, as a product designer, as a designer, we understand responsive design, and in the same vein, we should understand the tools used to build some of these experiences in AR, VR. Not coding, but the 3D space, communicating ideas, interactions, and just all of that. So some tools that you may be aware of course, like Adobe XD, Figma, and Sketch, they do have plugins for you to be able to design 2D UI components for a VR headset. However, one thing to note is that you're gonna have to change the dimensions massively. So design in there, test in the headset, and then scale up or down depending on what your results are. So regular design tools, cool, good to use. Sketching is really important for you to be able to communicate your ideas and storyboards, for example, while you learn these 3D tools. As I mentioned in a previous video, some modeling tools to mention is Blender, Maya, Cinema 4D. Now Blender is free, just don't forget that. And these are great for building objects quickly, also animating, and really getting the hang of things in general. These tools are big. They will take time, so take note of that. Don't feel bad. It's just all in all a learning experience. Storyboarding tools. What is storyboarding? Storyboarding, quite simply, and I have to look it up in case someone calls me out. Basically, it's creating a sequence of drawings that show the levels of a different scene or goal. You're basically painting the scene screen by screen. It's your fastest way to get your point across. Just think of it like that. Storyboarding tools, pen and paper, pencil and paper, but 3D, like if you have a headset, check out Sketchbox, Maquette, Tavori, Quill. These are really, really wonderful storyboarding tools in the actual headset. So if you have an Oculus, these are all free. So check them out, take a stab at them, and it will help you create a storyboard and also an immersive film. So you can actually animate with some of these. So really powerful, powerful tools. Last but not least, game engines. Now, most of these companies that you'll be applying to, if you apply to them, if you check out any job posting for a product designer within these XR companies, will absolutely ask you to know either Unity or Unreal. In Unity and Unreal, you will actually be able to build out your prototypes and test your prototypes. So this is 100% a big reason to not avoid this. You don't need to know how to code. You can just drag and drop things and create objects within that space and interactions. I'm not saying it is easy to learn, far from, but there are learning paths within these companies on their websites specifically aimed at designers to get them more involved. And this is really to take the load off of developers. Also, in order to be a stronger product designer and designer in general and team member, because all of these processes work within teams, it is always important for you to know the technology that you're working with. Now, this is pretty much the rundown. I know this is a lot of tools, however, think of the type of product designer or designer that you want to be, whether you want to be, and it always goes back to this conversation, whether you want to be a generalist or a, you know, specializing in a specific area. As usual, it always also goes back to being a generalist to be strong and just able to understand a lot and help out within teams before specializing, so that way you get a good idea of the lay of the land and what you do and don't like to do. And to be honest, this is often what I tell my students, because I'm a mentor at a design bootcamp. Try everything once. You know, maybe you might find that you really, really like creating environments within 3D space. Maybe you like creating objects specifically. Maybe you like doing the interaction part only. That is something to really consider in this process, in this learning journey for yourself. Okay, now since I think this video is kind of short, I pulled up a product designer position at Oculus and I want to run through this with you. Responsibilities, the minimum qualifications, preferred qualifications. La, 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 la. So, product designer for Oculus. Product design responsibilities, synthesize broad and ambiguous business requirements, accomplish them through design, help establish preliminary processes to align cross-functional teams. I'm gonna skip forward because a lot of this sounds like traditional product design roles, calculate design decisions. Yeah, so let's skip ahead for the minimum qualifications. Experience designing and experience managing and leading in cross-functional environments. 2 years of experience in shipping software products, doesn't specify. Knowledge of qualitative and quantitative methods of user research, including A/B testing frameworks, gotcha. Also doesn't specify what kind of medium. So if you have experience already with that within the web and app kind of industry, you are. Third bullet point, experience thinking about product strategy and vision, not just how it should look, but how we should build and why. Last bullet point, a portfolio featuring examples of both visual and interaction work. And now, for the preferred qualifications, Unity experience. So we gather that there is a mix of product design, typical product design responsibilities, and we also got the type of software they use and what we should really, after this, if you're interested, go head first into if you want to create and apply to be a product designer for Oculus. Now, if you are a 2D product designer like me and you have no idea where to get started, honestly, jumping into some of these tools that I mentioned today, if you're really interested into like just the creation process and actually being able to create some of these things, take a stab at one of these programs to get a good idea of what it's like to build some of these things. That's the approach I'm taking by creating little projects. And as I mentioned before, I have been offered positions. I have been offered small projects to work on. So there is a lot that goes into just creating these projects for yourself. It shows your passion. It shows your interest. It shows your, you know, your creativity, imagination, and your ability to solve the problems within these small projects that you create. And I literally always say this to all of my students, passion projects will always get you something, even if you weren't even looking at it. This has always been said to me as well. The creation process, your creative process, passion projects, someone is always looking, regardless of who you are or how little followers you have. Honestly, someone is always looking at what you're creating and seeing if you are continuing to create. So make those small projects, get exposure by them. That's essentially what you're doing, and have fun, because I find it easier to learn new things by having fun, by creating them in general. Plus, if you're like me, learning a lot of these tools gives you that creative freedom to be able to explore these new mediums and create through new lens, which I always find exciting, but that's why I created this channel to talk a little bit more about it. Now, to wrap this up, I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions about any one of the programs that I mentioned, leave a comment down below. As always, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!